feel very apprehensive.
You know, I don't like to be a shrinking violet.
We are challenging the perception of older people that they can act, they can act, they can dance, they can do whatever.
So it just gives me a sense of achievement, I suppose.
I kind of studied drama and I just thought when I started doing it, I felt that it was something I could do. Yeah, I'm Richard Carter and I'm an actor with, I'm the youngest actor with Third Thought Theatre. I've been with this theatre company for just over 6 years.
And she sunk in the bed and she was gone. And I sat back and I think, 92 years of age.
2 years ago, they wanted to become a company rather than a class of people who then went on and performed. My name's Peter Avery. This is what they wanted to do and this is what we're aiming to do. Try and make it an over 60s fringe company. But I'd had the idea for Paradise at the Venice Biennale. I'd been to see the Venice Biennale that year. And I'd gone to a strange exhibit, which was Brazilian. And then it was all about Paradise being a Rio flat in the 50s with the bossa nova playing all night, all day, all night. And I thought there's half an idea here. So I didn't base it on that. I just thought there's an idea somewhere.
Peter has a vision. And it takes you a long time to get... Well, my name is Tessa Brewer. It's very avant-garde. Peter does things and you think, I don't like that very much. No. And then you go into rehearsal and then it goes on for a little while and then you think that a mist seems to lift and you think, oh yeah, oh this is great.
The copper coloured mountains is to hold you there while you do
this.
But then, I can't see why you're not all then filtering into heaven.
And then he said about Paradise, he'd got this idea for Paradise, so would we interview people and ask their thoughts on Paradise?
I'm Vi Newman, and I'm one of the actresses involved in Third Thought Theatre Group.
And he had this, I've got this vision, I want it done in a tent.
And then talking to Jules Wilkinson, who's the BBC producer we'd just done a little bit of work with, came from that early talks came the idea of recording people all over London.
And with the letter H on it, standing for heaven, and these angels going in the line, playing a trumpet while you're walking in.
I tried to get them to not think too long about it. I just said, tell me what's the first thing that comes into your head when we say the term paradise.
Promise me a box of black magic chocolates and a bottle of brandy. That would have been what I thought was heaven.
Well, you've done 50 interviews out on the street. You've got a collage of hidden ideas because the voices are saying something, but you know underneath the voice they're saying something else.
It gives you a sense of belonging because you go to bed of a night and you think to yourself, well, I've put fruit on 5,000 people's food table this week.
I'm always glad when we've got the tricks over. So it's the opening, you know, the opening, and then whatever we do with the stick dance. And it's not that I find it particularly difficult, but I always think once we've got the tricks over, I kind of feel I know we're sailing. I kind of know my way around the show then. I like John sweeping up the stage, and I think Ting Tong looks visually rather nice because it has that rich, there's fans and that rich sort of unwinding of that sort of scarf around her. That looks very good.
For me, it wouldn't be having my partner turn around to me and saying, where you been? It's 2 o'clock in the morning, you big fat bastard. It would be, I'll come in, darling, I'll make you a nice cup of tea and a cheese sandwich, but that's not going to happen.
They said it's very awkward questions, but I don't know. I hope they're kidding. Yeah, my name is John Clayton. I can understand why people are hooked on acting. They get into acting, that's all they want to do, you know. I can understand that. Because it's there's a lot of emotion in that involved, you know. I don't feel egotistical about it or anything like that, but I feel really satisfied in myself that I've actually done that. If I can do something like that, all is not lost.
So we started then putting the recorded voices over music, and that's when the most interesting things happened.
Go, travel, jump to your feet, jump to your feet, and you've got to paddle, you've got to get it, get the air rushing into your ears. Go.
You're depending very much on the other people in the group with you, that they know their cues and you've got to go on. And that's where I think a small group like this, we do work together.
He loves the bearded lady. He loves the tattooed man.
Here comes the bubble queen.
How's the bubbles, Joan? Did you manage to blow a few?
Not too, I
have. Blowing bubbles.
No good.
Bubbles in the air.
It's not working.
Ooh, I'm not doing it.
Perform in different neighbourhoods, communities, and I think that the philosophy is that we want something to happen from that community. So hence, I think,
right,
that it's always a different group. So we have ones like a very small duo, two, a violinist and a guitarist.
I lost my red nose for a long time. Everybody said, no, I haven't had it. And then Richard said, I do apologise, I've got two red noses.
We just said we wish we could remember everything where we put things, and we can't. We have senior moments.
Because I always find, I can't find my red socks. I usually find one and the other one's disappeared. And Luke says, well, you do throw them. I said, well, I don't have time to do it.
But where are you going to hang it?
I seem to have mislaid my wonderful black and white skull cap.
It's in there. I saw it in there.
There's a lot of props in the show, and there's quite a lot of quick costume changes for us, for John and myself. So we're working on stage, but we're working off stage a lot, you know, just to be there in time.
Dirty, stinking
mud. There's such a tranquility about that garden scene. I don't know if it's the water or the music or whatever it is, but there is such a tranquility, a feeling of hope that something better is going to come in the future.
The reaction's been fantastic. I don't think they can believe that people that of our age can sort of do things.
They were so responsive today. They were really, really wonderful. And they seeing their faces all laughing and smiling and saying, oh, that was great, I thoroughly enjoyed it.
I like all the dancing and everything, but I like everything.
It was very funny, the dancing, and yeah, they looked really enthusiastic and everything. It was good. I wouldn't expect anything like that.
Visually, I thought it was really exciting and interesting, and I loved the thoughts. It was really thought-provoking, and at times moving, and at times very funny. So yeah, I liked it.
We hate saying it's over 60s, really, but sometimes you have to do that too, well, for all sorts of reasons, like funding reasons, or to make it, to some extent, for the press, of interest under those terms. But there's one area we do completely avoid, which is reminiscence. Reminiscence is very particular to over 60s and a lot of other work. Not saying it's not good, just that I don't want to do it. Or we don't want to do it, because it seems to me you're just trading on over 60s actors' pasts. And I think, you know, when you're doing a show, you're looking forward all the time.
Wonderful to do things like this and become involved I mean, it's been a godsend to me working with Peter, because it's something that I thought I wouldn't be able to do anyway. And, you know, the fact that I am doing this is great.
This one was the best, I think, and we had an extremely nice audience.
Oh, it was lovely.
It was fabulous. And in the end, they all danced with us, and it was like, really, they joined in the party of paradise.
As we go when tomorrow night comes. Oh, and then I haven't got to get up for a while, have a rest. As my daughter says, Mum, why are you busy? Keep going. And then you can rest on the days you're not doing anything.